Kristan Higgins. I'm the author of 7 romantic comedies for HQN, and my latest book coming out in November is called Until There Was You. Until There Was You is, in a sense, a classic one of my stories. It's about a heroine in a small town who is involved with the hero with whom she's had some history. They knew each other in high school. And in many ways, it delivers on a lot of the aspects that my readers have come to expect. For the first time, I'm writing the hero's point of view. And I guess I did that because, for two reasons. I know a lot of readers have asked for it. And as much as I love first person, I thought maybe it was time for a change. And also because this particular hero, Liam, definitely had a lot going on in his life. And I wanted to show readers that and let them really get into his head. His marriage wasn't perfect, and he's coming home to confront a lot of issues that he felt should have been put to rest already. I didn't always want to write contemporary romance. I actually thought that I would write a dark historical, and that was where my talent might lie. So I wrote a 93-page outline of a very dark historical set in Ireland, big culture clash, and it was a very dark story. The hero was an abused child, and the heroine was from abject poverty. And just to make sure that it was cheerful enough, I said it during the potato famine, you know, the po-fam genre of historical novels. And I thought it was wonderful. I had a big 93-page outline. I went to my first writer's conference, and I thought, there's going to be a bidding war over this thing. I just know it. And quickly learned that outlines don't sell, and that what I wanted to write was not what someone wanted to read. So I quickly decided I'll write a book that I would love to read and that I think everybody would like to read. I'll write an every woman hero. I'll make it funny, light, but with a lot of heart too. Going from potato famine romance writer to New York Times bestseller was a pretty smart choice. I definitely found my voice with contemporary romance and romantic comedy too. You know, a lot of readers say, I was laughing my head off on one page and I was crying the next. And I love that as a reader myself. So the books caught on very quickly, and Harlequin did a great job getting behind me and promoting me. And my last book hit the New York Times list. So that was absolutely thrilling. It's every author's dream come true. Writing as a career, I love. I'm a solitary person by nature, so I love the ability to go to my office and sit there and just immerse myself in the story and the characters, in their issues, their families. And definitely the best part of being a writer is when I get a letter from someone who said, I read your book at a very difficult time in my life. I read your books and they made me smile and they made me laugh and they took me away from my troubles for a little while. You know, that's just priceless. You just can't even describe how that feels. Next up, I'm going to be trying my hand at a series, I think, and I love the idea of family, so this would be a series involving a family, and I'm setting it around a vineyard in the Finger Lakes region of upstate New York because it's such a beautiful area, and I love the idea of a family business and the kind of trials and tribulations you have when you have to deal with your siblings, not just on a family level, but on a business level as well. A book that I'm working on right now involves a character from one of my older books, Parker from The Next Best Thing. She was the children's author of a very popular and saccharine book series about child angels. And she finds herself in very different circumstances, and she needs to spend the summer up in Gideon's Cove, Maine, which is the setting from Catch of the Day. So a lot of readers have asked to see what happens to Maggie and Malone from Catch of the Day, and a lot of them really loved Parker, so I decided to give her a story and kind of bring those two together. So I'm really looking forward to that, and I think my readers will be very happy to revisit some old friends.